Governors elected on the platform of the People's Democratic Party have expressed sadness that the president, Muhammadu Buhari, and his all-progressive Congress regime have not only widened Nigeria's fault lines with divisive actions, but have also supervised the nation's slide into extreme decay within just 5 years in power. The governor, Aminu Tambuwal-led PDP Governors Forum, also said in spite of enviable strides recorded since independence 60 years ago, the nation seems to be on reverse gear with the current state of affairs. And joining us live is Segun Shoumi, the PDP chieftain and former spokesman to Abubakar Atiku. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Would you say this is a fair statement to make, especially as your party has led the country for a longer period?
I think this longer period argument is a bit embarrassing for people that really reflect. The whole idea of democracy suggests that some parties will win today and other parties will be in charge. But the people have to do comparison with what's going on with their lives. They have 16 years of Nigerian rule under PDP granted. It's not Ururu, they didn't solve all the problem, but there are quite a lot of milestones that we can easily benchmark. The economy was depressed when we took it. We left it very vibrant and made it the biggest economy in Africa. We were now grouped with Brazil, Indonesia, and some of the other great nations. That's why we left the economy. We opened it up, more people had more money, we created more jobs. Look, I don't want to rehash the 16 years. We're back to the 5 years of the Buhari presidency. What have they done? They can say whatever they want, they can put speeches together, they can organize a lot of hot words, but the reality is, how do the Nigerians feel? How much are they paying for food now? How are they able to access healthcare? What exactly has happened to education? What's wrong? What has become the state of life? What is the level of poverty? What is the fault line in the country? And by fault line, it's important to know that there must be a reason why we should ask, why is every part of Nigeria now wanting out? It's down to the fact that the level of nepotism of the Buhari administration has made it so. We run a country that is very diverse, made up of a lot of people, a lot of tribes, and obviously a lot of interest. All of the years, especially the PDP years, great effort was placed on ensuring that we were very inclusive. We didn't run a government where anybody could easily say one section of the country was running away with all the appointment or was made to be more superior than the others. What has happened now? And when the Nigerian people see this continuously over 5 years, and then they begin to react with everybody wanting out, with crisis in the northern region, crisis everywhere, then you have to say that the comments of the Nigerian Governors Forum is well placed. And I think those comments are not so much to irritate anybody, but to let all of us know that we have a bit of time now. The Buhari administration has a bit of time to correct some things if they can. And then the Nigerian people too, they have an opportunity of understanding that what democracy offers is the opportunity for them to choose. And you have a lot of parties in the country, the PDP being one of them. Therefore, when it is time for elections, Nigerians cannot but place all the interest in it. We will agitate, we will advocate, we will explain that let's have a clean, credible, clear election. But the bottom line is that our electoral process belongs to us Nigerians. And it is whatever we make of it that we're going to be able to get. If you do not choose to be interested in who governs, from the local government right down to the state, up to the federal level, then you have to ask yourself, right, what exactly do you think?
Hold on.
The party in power is the one that is having to deal with a referendum of some sort. A referendum in the sense that people can pick a view based on what they see as the policies of that government.
Kindly hold on, sir. I want us to move in a different direction.
They're intolerant of opinions from leaders. They're intolerant of people who advocate. They're intolerant of people who do protest. They're intolerant of freedom of gathering. It's a bit too much.
All right, let's move to the north now. Governor Tambuwal of Sokoto State said himself and his colleagues feel the pain of Nigerians in the northeast and in the northwest. Do you think that the problems facing the north really is a party problem, or it is a problem based on or leadership problem in general?
Well, I don't think it's a party problem really, but look, somebody had the buck stops on someone's table. And the way we have configured our country, albeit in a faulty manner, the buck seems to stop at the table of the president. Because we have created a very wobbled federated system where so much power belongs to one section of the tiers of government. the states can't create their own police. They don't have so much they can bring to the table around security. Therefore, if there's a breakdown of security anywhere, you're going to have to look at Mr. President. And when you're looking at the president, obviously the president did not stroll into the villa on his own without a party. That's where it brings the party in. Policies of government are going to be evaluated according to how they are, the people see them. So in terms of what's happening in the northern flank of the country, the Buhari presidency has made it worse.
Okay. And also,
a governor who is not a sub-target is targeted like three times within a very short time. What the hell is going on here?
All right. I also want to give you an opportunity.
Asking, oh, why don't you call people from Chad to come and help us? When did we become such a country? And you have service chiefs that are sitting down there forever and ever, amen. And you're asking, if they're not delivering on the job, why are you keeping them?
I also want to give you an opportunity to talk solutions now. As an opposition party, or the biggest opposition party, I believe, in the country currently, let's talk solutions. What would you say is the way forward? How, differently maybe would, your party have done things?
Let's start with the president that is in charge now, smelling the coffee and understanding that we cannot insist that the restructuring conversation won't take place. If we've tried it for 60 years and it's not giving us the kind, it's not giving the Nigerians generally the kind of acceptability of performance like they want, and it seems to be that a larger number of the sections of the country are unhappy with the way the country is being governed, then that's a good enough reason to say, okay, let's go talk about that. So maybe you can do restructuring or find a way to give us a more equitable federation. Then if you're talking in terms of security, I've argued over and over and over again, and for the opting time, I'm going to put it again. You cannot police a large nation like Nigeria if you don't even know who the Nigerians are, where they are, where they reside. I've been screaming my lungs past by saying that you need to have a biometric capture of Nigerians and everybody in Nigeria through a verifiable address. It's the minimum, so you know where you can find them. And then, when was the last time we even did a census in this country? Well, it becomes such a joke, even that by our own assessment that we're meant to do census periodically every 10 years, we've not even been able to do that.
All right, thank you very much.
And then you cannot have this humongous
we're out of time for
being
this conversation.
Of police from only one
Hello, hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.